Last time we read Jack Kent's story about Just Joey and his mum didn't want him to get lost. This time we've got Joey Runs Away by Jack Kent. What's going to happen? Why is Joey running away? So there he is, running away, but we don't know why yet, do we? No idea why Joey would run away. Joey, clean up your room, Mother Kangaroo said. I've told you 100 times. 8 times, muttered Joey. He had kept count. So he's playing rather than helping Mum clean up his room. He's playing with a kite. Like all kangaroo children, Joey lived in his mother's pocket. At the moment, though, everything was a jumble. There was hardly any room for Joey to turn around. Joey sighed and went to clean up his room. There he is, he's taking his kite with him. But he took one look at the mess and decided it would be easier to run away from home. There he is. Mum's having a rest. So he did. There he is, packs his little bag, puts it on his shoulder and runs away. You're being awfully quiet, Joey, Mother said after a while. Have you finished your cleaning your room? There wasn't any answer. She looks in her tummy. Joey, Mother called. She looked in her pocket to see what he was up to. But he was nowhere in sight. We know he's run away, don't we? He's hiding. Oh, find him, little rascal, said Mum. But he wasn't under the bed. And he wasn't behind the drawer. Behind the dresser. He wasn't anywhere. Look, he's had a really good look and he's not there. Mother saw a small piece of paper. It was a note written in crayon and the note said, I have run away. Goodbye, Joey. Joey's gone, said Mother. And she started to cry. Then she started to look for Joey. Word soon got round that Joey's mother had an empty room. Might be somewhere to stay, lots of thinking. Several folks came to ask about the room. It's not to rent, said Mother. But they looked it over. Imagine a bear or an elephant coming to stay in Joey's room. They even tried it out. There's a cow and a giraffe sitting in Joey's mother's pouch. But they decided it wasn't right for any of them. There's the rabbit family trying it out. It's Joey's room, said Mother. Meanwhile, Joey was trying to find a new place to live. Oh, yes. So he's lost his bedroom and he's trying to find somewhere to live. Every kangaroo mother's pouch was already filled. Look, all the mums. There's no room for Joey. Anyone else's pouch? Joey found a pelican whose pouch was empty. It's not a pouch, is it? Isn't that his beak? Very strange. And he moved in. Look, sitting in the pelican's pouch. It's pretty odd, isn't it? It was very comfortable, but sometimes it was a bit scary. Lying up high. When he takes off. Joey decided to look some more. When the postman started his rounds the next day, he noticed that his pouch seemed heavier than usual. Who's in the postman's pouch? It's Joey. He thinks the postman's bag is somewhere to stay. As he bounced along, Joey thought that it wasn't like his mother's pouch at all, and it made him feel very homesick. Late in the afternoon, when the postman delivered the bills to Joey's mother, a few bills, said the postman as he handed them to her, a letter, a magazine, some junk mail. Hmm. is Joey. And that's his mom. I wonder if she recognizes him. Oh, and I think this is yours, he said, lifting Joey out of his pouch. Where have you been? Mother asked between hugs and kisses. I was looking for a place to live, said Joey. What do you think Mummy says? Well, it just so happens I have an empty room, said Mum. See what you think of it. Joey hopped right in. He was very happy to be home again. It's just right, he said. Back in his mummy's pouch. It just needs to be cleaned up a little, Joey said, and he got right to work. Just as he should have done at the beginning. He ran away, remember? And so that's Joey runs away, and Joey comes home again to find his mum. That's the end of the story.